Hi everybody, this is Tom from Screen Printing Artist, screenprintingartist.com. Make sure to go in and sign up for my newsletter and you can get my latest courses. Let's go ahead and jump into this design here. We're going to make a grunge design today. There's a little difference between a distressed design and a grunge design. I'll go into that. First, as always, you want to start by typing in all your copy that you're going to use. Nice square font because I want to make it. I want to make kind of a blocky looking font, which works well for grunge designs. So we can kind of move this one down, move this one up, down, and then enlarge this. Let's look at the total size of this and make sure we're sized. We don't want to go up to 14, we'll stay around 12. So right about there. I'm going to adjust my kerning with the shape tool. So you squeeze the shape, the size of the font there. Let it go. And I'm going to hit here. And you hold the shift key, click here. And then if you hit the right, it aligns to the right. And in this case, it aligns to the left. And I'll move it down here. Move it up. And then we're going to just expand everything just a little bit. I'm going to get it a little bit taller. And I'm going to make two lines, or like rectangles. I'm going to click here, hold the shift key, and then again left or right. In this case, we'll go right, and then I'll duplicate this, control D, and then I'll go B is for bottom when I shift click here, and then I'll click here, and then hold that, and then hit right, and then left. So I hit L, and it aligns to the left, and then I can shorten it a little bit. Here. Now let's see about the size of this. Click here. It's about almost a half an inch. So I'm going to just, well, this is clicked, so it's locked. I'm going to go ahead and hit 0.5 just so that everything's the same size. And then I'll click here and let me hit the right key again. So it aligns it to the right. I'll click here, bring it back in. And then this one will go 0.5 too. So it'll be the same size here. Right. Oops, left. Click here. So the R key or the L key to align to the right or left. And then this, I want this to be just a little bigger than that. So we'll go, let's see, maybe 6.5. So 0.65. And I'm pretty much done with it being type because I don't really need for it to be editable text anymore. So I can shrink it just a little bit. I just adjust the kerning with the shape tool. Let's see here. About 6.5, maybe just a hair bigger. Let's go up to 0.7. Click here and hit right, left. There we go, centered. And this, click here, and then B is on the bottom. So it aligns for the bottom. And then I can fill this with black, no outline. And then I can move this over. It's like just underneath that, and then here, over here, so it'll be the same thing, black, and then right click on nothing, so there's no outline right here, and then this, I'll align to the bottom here, and what I want is, I want this type, I'm going to break this, control K, it breaks it apart, and then I want these two, I'm going to scoot those over. I'm going to recombine them, so click, hold shift, control L, and then I'll take some of the kerning out, just like I did up there, up here, and then this one, I'm going to go the same size as this, and this is 0.7, so this one, I'm going to do 0.7, hit enter, and then I'm going to align it, hit click this, and then hit T for top, and then I'll move it over here, just so it's about the same distance from here to here. I'm going to control L, oops, I mean control Q, so I convert them all to curves. So this is a curve, now control Q, and then here, control Q. Okay, so this over. So just about the same amount of space. And now I want to make sure there's enough same amount of space here. So one thing we can do is just take a rectangle here and just draw it just as a reference. And then I'll drag it down and right click. Make sure it's the same size. Grab all this. Nudge it up using the nudge keys. Just sort of the same distance right there. Almost done with that. Delete. Now I want to kind of customize this a little bit. I'm going to hit Control S, save it, and I want to customize this font. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come in here and just cut a quick stencil in this font. So I'm just going to make a thin little, for the sake of the reference point, I'll just make it green right now. And I'm going to cut this thin little line here. I'm not going to do the J, I'll just do the U. I'm going to cut it a little bit thinner, just about half the distance of this width here. Right there, I'm just going to cut it there, and then I'm going to drag it over and right click, and then I'm going to drag it over here, and bring it up there, just about even with that, and right click there. And so about half the distance, the skinniest width between the cuts there. I'm going to come out here, and I'm going to edit this part of it, convert this to curves, Control Q, and then just real quick, grab it here. Again, about half the distance of this. So I'll grab this, just for reference, I'll make it green. Then I'll drag it over and right click right here. I'm just gonna make it a little longer. Same thing. Just try to match it up to the edge of that one side. Right click there. Drag it over, hold the shift key to keep it on the same line, and then right click. Drag it over. Time for the E and right click, and in this case I'm going to drag it up and just drag it up. I'll align it as much as I can with the top, that way if it takes a chunk out it won't look weird there. And then what you do is just come in here and you just combine all those pieces, Control L, and then click here and go up to the property bar and just say trim, and then click here and delete, and then it makes it into a stencil. So and then here, which is a nice look, Control L, combine them all, hold the shift key, click there, trim, grab them, delete. You can see that's kind of a nice look. So go down here and finish right here. I just do this kind of quick, just come through, and again, you're just creating a line about half the distance of your skinniest line here. For reference, I'll make it green just so it's easy to see. I'm not going to do anything on the I or the L because I mostly want the lines to be vertical in nature for this, click here, and then again I try to line it on the E on the top and the bottom, so if it does take a chunk out, it won't look weird. Click over here, hold the shift key, and then right click, and then we'll go a little bit bigger, so I'll grab this, right click, since the font's a little bit bigger, I'll enlarge it just a little bit, drag it up, click, drag over, hold the shift key, right click, and the other two are L's, so good on there. I'll just grab them all, Control L, combine them, hold the shift key, click here, make sure I click there. Oh, these are separate, so I want to combine those first so I can do it in one shot. So I Control L on there, and then these are one curve, and I hold the shift key, click, and then trim, and then click here and delete. And so then you've got this, everything on here is a stencil now. Click out. And the downside of that, of course, is you can't edit your text now if you want to change the font, but for us we're okay here. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and enlarge this if I need to, because right now I'm about 10 inches, so I'm going to group it for now and then just enlarge it to my max print size, which will be 12.5, 12.5, enlarge, and I'll hit the P key, center it to the page, I'll save it, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of skew it just a little bit like this. And then I'll hit P again. And then see, it bumps it up to 13. So I'm going to reduce it now to 12.5. Just so I'm not too big. And just optical wise, sometimes it's an optical illusion, but this looks like it's sticking out a little bit more than I want. So I just hold the Control key, go ahead. And this is still a rectangle, you can see down here. So I need to Control Q. And now I can edit it directly with the nodes. And I can just bump those over if I want. Just bump it over a little bit. That way it's not sticking too far. far out. It makes it a little bit more, again, personal preference right there. I'm going to save it. And now we're going to grunge this thing out. So how are we going to grunge it? Well, I'm going to create a background just for reference here. Let's create like a charcoal shirt that it's going to go on. Right click and shift page down. And then this print right here, we need some grunge effects to kind of rough it up. So we downloaded some. These are some that are available on different websites. This one we got off of freepik.com. You get a membership there. You get lots of nice little grunge graphics here. And these help out because they shorten the time it takes to do this sort of thing. I'm going to go ahead and do the grunge part first, and then I'll do a distress on top. So the grunge part, I just need pieces for this. So I'm going to use some of these. I'm going to grab these. Let me back out here. And these are vectors that you can have. And I'm going to click here and click there. So I'm going to grab these. I'm going to leave this alone for now. And I'm just going to copy them. And then go ahead and paste. And what we're going to do now is we're going to use this. This is like a this one, and especially this one, because there's a lot of pieces. You can see there's, you know, this has a lot of pieces on it, so that'll be kind of useful. And so what I like to do first is I'll create like an augment to this. So I'm going to take this and make it, let's go ahead and make it white, just so we can see what we're doing. And these I'm going to put in the center here. Put one there, and then one down here, and I'll rotate it just so it doesn't look the same. And then I'll do another one maybe here and rotate it. And we're just creating pieces that are going to kind of stick out. And again, you want to rotate them so they don't look real similar to the other ones that you've done already. And just combine it right here. And then all these, I'll group them. I'll group them, and then you can change them white. And you can see how that kind of adds that effect there. And then these, we can shrink this a little bit. Just a little bit. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make that the same color. And this is, you can see that's like 80% gray. So I'm going to make that 80% gray right here. Fill it. And then this is going to knock out portions of my design here, depending on where I go with it. And again, I'll rotate it so it doesn't... you know, it'll kind of cut across my design a little bit in spots. And you can, you know, you just play with them. Like, use them like brushes, kind of. You just rotate them. Just see where they hit your design a little bit. That's pretty good. And then I want to put a couple of drips in here. I think I'll use these, so I'm going to take this, and these drips might be a little big, but I'll use them right here. Can do one right on this, here, do one here, and then do one like right, I don't really want to hit my other type, so we'll do one coming down. And we'll just kind of group these together. Group, make them white. And then now I'm just going to create an overall distress on this whole thing. So I think I want one more little splatter here. So I just clicked in holding the control key. Control and make it a child curve selection. Control C, Control V. So you make an extra piece. And then I'll shrink it a little bit. And that way I can rotate it. Whoops. Rotate. Got to click it again to rotate. There. Can add that, and then I can use it in a couple other spots too, just to add a little bit more to this. There we go. And then I didn't. You notice I didn't knock out too many spots because I'm going to put a distress on here. So I can group everything before I distress it. Group, and then I'm going to go ahead and go to page 2. I'm going to grab my distress. Now, I was going to use this distress here. Now, you're going to see that this is a lot of pieces, though. This is a group of like 13,000 pieces. So what I want to do, I'm going to enlarge this a little bit. instead of using 13,000 pieces in my design and trying to output it, which is going to create a huge file, it's going to be hard to rip, I'm going to enlarge it enough that it's going to overlap my design, and I'm going to convert it into what's called a monochrome bitmap. So I'm going to enlarge it enough, and I'm going to say bitmap, convert to bitmap, just to save the size here. Say 600 dpi is pretty good. Wait, let's go to convert to bitmap here. Bitmap mode, convert to bitmap 600, and we'll just go to grayscale first, and then we can convert it to black. We'll just go right to black and white. I think that'll be good. Just say okay, and see, now it converts it all to black and white. But the nice thing about that is it's a lot easier for the software to. When I go back to page, if it's off the page, it stays floating here on desktop. Then I can right-click and kind of turn it. So it could be going this way. In this case, I think I'll leave it this way. And what I'll do is I'll do half here, and then I'll do the other half like up, and this way, and then I fill it with nothing, and then I right-click with the background. And you can see how it kind of knocks out chunks of my design. I'm going to shrink it a little bit just so the distress is a little bit finer. Go like that and that. And then I can always stretch it too and make sure it's overlapping the whole thing. There. Now sometimes if your distress is too much on your design, like if it's not working completely, you can adjust the size, you know. You can make it larger or smaller. In this case, it's pretty close to what I want. And if you have two pieces like that, what you can do is you can just take a square that fits over your whole design like this, and you can just fill it with like a power clip of these two. So you just take these two, group them, and then you just say effects, power clip, and then place inside frame, and then just throw them inside this frame. And that way, they're not hanging off the edge of your design if you want to show it to a customer or that sort of thing. This is a good way to kind of start out with the distress. Now, you could do it. You could leave it white on this gray shirt. It might be cool. A lot of people like black on the gray shirt. So if you wanted to go that route, you would just edit. You go find and replace, place objects, and then you just have to replace everything that's white with black. In this case, I'm going to go with the deepest black I have, which will be a RGB. Just for sending it as a fill, say finish and replace all. And I'll go through and place all. And then you're ready to go here. And that's one way to kind of make a quick grunge design with a distress overlay in CorelDRAW.